After passing the toughest crackdown on illegal immigration, Arizona just passed a new law that places restrictions on what are called ethnic studies classes in the public school system. The new law prohibits courses that promote the overthrow of the U.S. government, that promote resentment toward a race or class of people, or are designed primarily for pupils of a particular ethnic group, or advocate ethnic solidarity instead of the treatment of pupils as individual citizens. Should ethnic studies classes be taught? And Arizona lawmakers aiming to eliminate the coursework altogether. Well, we'll see. Doug Nick is the federal liaison for the Arizona Department of Education. He works for the Arizona government. And Mark Lamont Hill is a professor of education and African American studies at Columbia. Let me go to Doug first. Doug, you're first here. Explain the classes that have been given in Arizona that you now wish to stop.
Well, the situation came to light about 4 years ago. My boss, Superintendent Tom Horn, and our deputy, Margaret Dugan, were made aware by some teachers down at the Tucson Unified District that there were schools, or classes rather, that were directed specifically towards segregating people and students into racial and ethnic backgrounds. So you have African American studies and Asian studies and Native American studies, and then you have Chicano or Raza studies, Raza meaning race. And we were concerned because what we were hearing from some teachers down there was that specifically in the case of the Raza studies, some of the students were essentially becoming radicalized through a rather radical notion of the idea that the southwestern United States, places like Arizona, New Mexico, California, all the way up in some cases to Wyoming, all these states that are part of this country and have been for obviously many years, are really part of what is called Aztlan, and that students should be encouraged, if only by sheer numbers of population and growing and through illegal immigration, if need be, should come in and reconquer, or reconquista would be the word.
To make the point, who came up with these textbooks? Are they in the textbooks, this theology or philosophy you're describing of sort of separation again? Is there something in the textbooks that makes this case that you can point to?
Absolutely. There are several textbooks. There's one that uses the term the pedagogy of oppression. So what we're doing is we're taking 15 and 16-year-old students and we're telling them, you may not realize you're oppressed. We actually had a student come up to the legislature and testify to this effect. When she was a freshman, she started this class, and after the end of the class, she realized, oh, I am in fact oppressed, when before she didn't feel that way. Well, why is that? That's indoctrination. We have a text called Occupied America, which talks about how the Chicano population, Hispanic population needs to rise up and smash the gringo. It's very inflammatory language, and it's inappropriate in an educational
context. I'm stunned. I thought I knew a lot about American politics. Professor, I didn't know this kind of stuff was being taught. What do you make of it, Professor?
Well, first of all, that's not what's happening. It is possible that there are a few rogue teachers somewhere who are going above and beyond what the curriculum suggests. But Pedagogy of the Oppressed, as was just referenced, is not a book about overthrowing a government. It's not about convincing students that they're oppressed. It's a book about actually multiculturalism. It's a book about progressive education. In fact, the book is used in education schools all around the country to encourage dialoguing with students and doing group work and all the things that No Child Left Behind now calls for. You know, this ethnic studies is not about divisiveness. It's not about separating people from America. It's letting people know that they're more involved in America. We've always had ethnic studies. It's just the ethnicities that we focused on were European. They were Irish, they were Polish, they were Russian. Mm-hmm. And now we're saying there are other people who also have ethnicities who count as well. And it's also factually untrue to say that the purpose of ethnic studies is to put black people on one track and Chicanos on another track. No. White people will take Africanist or African-American studies. Black people will take Asian studies. The point is to expose everyone to the range of cultures and ethnicities that makes America good.
Back to you, Doug. Your thoughts. So explain the pedagogy of the oppressed and how you believe it clearly makes an ideological statement.
Well, that is just one of the texts. The other text is called Occupied America, in which it talks about smashing the gringo. And there are many, many other examples that we have found not only through our own investigation. We have read the curriculum. We have spoken to teachers down there. The very idea that in 2010 we would go back decades and decades to a very dark time in this country in which segregation was accepted, and then go back to segregation and saying, if you are Hispanic American or you are an African American, you must take a certain track of ethnic studies, is completely against the notion. As my boss talks about with Dr. King's speech in 1963, where people should be judged for the content of their character, not based on the color of their skin or ethnicity. This is exactly what's not happening in these studies.
A lot of these kids come from families that came from Mexico or Colombia or Guatemala, mostly from Mexico. Is there something inherently wrong in them taking a class or two in high school that explains their heritage?
Of course
where they
not.
Came from?
We would absolutely support a comprehensive curriculum that does, in fact, cherish other cultures, not excluding and certainly not segregating by race. That is exactly the opposite of the message that American public education should be doing.
But that's it's factually untrue to suggest that the curriculum advises teachers to separate people by race. And even if that were the case, that's not an argument for getting rid of ethnic studies. That's an argument for amplifying ethnic studies and diversifying ethnic studies so that everyone has access to it. But that's not what the initial intention of it was.
I have to say, in practice, though, that's a non sequitur because it does, in fact, it absolutely positively separates students by their ethnicity.
That's absolutely.
Why else would you call it African American studies or Rasa studies?
Because
by its very nature, it should be. You can certainly teach this in world history, American history.
That's not true at all.
And in fact, the standards of Arizona, which the chairman, the president of the History Channel television network came here a few years ago, she said she had read the history standards for all 50 states, and Arizona's were head and shoulders above the other 49. That's how much we value.
Here's the reality. It's called African American studies because they're the focus of the curriculum. It's not a non sequitur. Students in America take European history. It doesn't mean you have to be European to take it. It just means that that's the subject that you're studying. We want all students to take ethnic studies. We want all students to take Asian studies. All students to take African American studies because they all make up America, and that's what we want them to have access to. And if people are dividing people by race tracks, then that's a problem. But that's not an argument against ethnic studies. That's an argument on a school level for how people are administering the program. And lastly, all data. All data suggests that students who have access to ethnic studies programs do better on the high-stakes tests. They do better on the AIMS tests than people who don't take it. So even in terms of the educational aims of the state, it makes educational sense to take these courses for everybody.
There's absolutely no
reason.
Well,
what about that point, Doug? Isn't it a way, I'm not going to make a side here, but isn't it make a case, if you're like first-generation American, your parents are from Mexico or somewhere else, doesn't it encourage that kid to take more of an interest in studying in English, studying in school, which is going to help him become more assimilated, if part of that education includes something about where he came from?
There's absolutely no reason why we would oppose the idea of learning about other cultures. It is the
one your parents came from. No, with a particular emphasis on the one your parents came from. You see something wrong with that? I'm just trying to be honest here. Do you see something wrong with that?
I see something wrong when you take kids and say, because you are of a particular racial construct, which is a human construct, it is not something that is anything but what humans have placed upon themselves, to say you're going to be divided by race. I thought we were beyond that. We should be beyond that.
In Arizona, you thought we were beyond
standards
that?
Based yes, we are, in fact.
You don't see any irony in being from Arizona and saying you think we're beyond distinguishing people on the basis of race?
I see no irony in that? I see a lot of irony in somebody telling me that simply because I'm from Arizona, I somehow must take a certain point of view. That, sir, is stereotypical, and
exactly,
I do reject
that. Exactly, which is why I didn't say that. What I said is you're in the midst of a state that is engaged in a set of policy practices that hinge upon race. I don't know you. I don't know what your beliefs are, but you're in the midst of a state that depends on these practices.
Okay, you know, this
isn't
a bad argument.
And that's precisely why we need this curriculum.
You know what? This isn't a bad argument.